We have a great story again this week. It's called The Elves and the Shoemaker. This is a favorite story with children. I remember when I was little and I liked it. So here we go. Once upon a time, a shoemaker lived with his wife above his workshop. He was a good man. He worked hard and he helped all his neighbors, but he was very poor. And the day came when he only had enough leather to make one pair of shoes, and he was kind of sick. Things weren't going well, and well, he cut out the leather, but he was too tired to sew them up since he wasn't feeling well, and he went up to bed. But he left all the stuff on the workbench, and he was going to start it again the next morning. "I'll be able to make a better pair of shoes after I've had a good night's sleep," he told his wife as they went upstairs. Here they are. The next morning, bright and early, the shoemaker went downstairs to get started on his work. But what a surprise he had. On his workbench, where the leather had been, there was a brand new pair of shoes. And they were neatly and perfectly made, with not one single stitch out of place. "Whoa, these shoes are masterpieces," the shoemaker exclaimed to his wife. He put them in the window of his store, hoping that someone would come to buy them. Sure enough, a finely dressed young man entered the workshop and tried on the shoes. They fit him perfectly, and they were so handsome that the man happily paid a high price for them. With that money, the shoemaker was able to buy enough leather to make two pair of shoes. But by the time he returned to his shop, he was tired because he still didn't feel real well and it had been a long day. So he cut out the leather, left it on the workbench, intending to come down the next morning and get an early start. And off he went. Upstairs to bed. The next morning, the shoemaker had another surprise. There on the workbench were two new pairs of shoes. They were even more beautiful than that pair the day before, and they were just as perfectly made. The shoemaker put them in the window, and before lunchtime, he sold both pairs of shoes for a very good price. And now he had enough money to buy leather for four pairs of shoes. Wow. Fancy, fancy. Once again, he cut out the leather, left it on his workbench, and went up to bed. And once again, he came down the next morning to find more beautiful shoes, all made up and perfectly stitched. The same thing happened every day for a week. Look at that. The shoes began appearing as if by magic, the shoemaker told his wife. But somebody must have made them. Who do you think did it? "Let's stay up tonight and watch," his wife suggested. "Maybe we can find out." Thank you. that night, the shoemaker left some leather all cut up and ready to sew on his workbench, just as usual. Then, instead of going to bed, he and his wife hid behind a curtain at the back of the shop. There they waited, and they waited. And they waited. They were just about ready to go to bed when at the stroke of midnight, the shop door opened, and in danced two tiny little elves. They skipped up to the workbench and quickly began to sew the leather into fine new shoes. As they worked, they sang, "We will sew and we will stitch to help the shoemaker grow rich." Soon the shoes were finished and the little elves jumped off the workbench and danced out the shop. "Those kind little elves have helped us," said the shoemaker, astonished. "We must repay them."
Did you see how thin their clothes were?" his wife asked. "And their little feet. Their little feet were bare. Those poor little guys must be freezing to death. Let's make them some warm clothes and show them how grateful we are," said the shoemaker. "Look at that. They're going right through the snow in their little bare feet. Look at that."
The next day, the shoemaker's wife knitted two cozy warm jackets, two little scarves, two pair of warm pants, and the shoemaker used his finest leather to make two little pairs of boots. That night, instead of leaving leather on his workbench, the shoemaker left the clothes all wrapped up in shiny paper and ribbons. Then he and his wife hid behind the curtain again to wait. At the stroke of midnight, the shop door opened, and in danced the little elves. They hopped up on the workbench, and they saw the presents had been left for them. They opened them at once, and in a twinkling of an eye, they dressed in their brand new clothes. They knew the presents were from the shoemaker's way of saying thank you. And they did a happy dance together, singing, "Now the shoemaker's grown rich, there's no need to sew and stitch." Then they hopped off the workbench and scurried out the door. The shoemaker and his wife never again saw the elves, but their troubles were over, and they had a good and happy life together for many long years, because they were able to buy good food and medicine, and the shoemaker got all better, and what did they do? They were able to start helping other people again, right? Isn't that a great story? Why did the shoemaker help those little elves? He did it to say thank you, didn't he? He didn't just say, "Wow, look at this, cool, let's keep it going." When people do nice stuff for us all the time, we can always say thank you, right? Thank you isn't hard to do. We say thank you, and then we see if we can do something nice for them, right? You can help your mama or your grammy or whoever takes care of you during the day and helps you with your schoolwork. Can you help the big person? You can help wash dishes or sweep the floor, but you can always say thank you, and you can always have a good attitude, right? Obey with a happy heart and work hard on your schoolwork, right? That's the best way to say thank you. Good story, isn't it? Well, another one next week.